Bordenham Mona need to go back to the drawing board and apply for the licence in terms of peat harvesting, to recommence peat harvesting. We have a desperate situation now where Bordenham Mona, hundreds of Bordenham Mona workers are facing job losses, and there's 17,000 people in the horticulture sector across this state also facing job losses. We're seeing unhinged environmental policies coming into play, which Fine Gael and Fianna Fáil are more than happy to preside over. But what I've said to them is, as a TD that comes from the Midlands and understands the issues, that the Midlands is a region that has been disadvantaged. We have the second lowest rate of disposable income in the whole state. So every job we have currently is precious. And what I've said to the government is, we should have had up to 2030 for the just transition to take place. Indeed, if it was just, that would have happened. But unfortunately, what's happening now, as I see clearly from the people I speak to on the ground, is that workers, communities and enterprises are being left behind. These are people with mortgages the government doesn't care about. We're hearing about these harebrained policies and ideas. We're hearing these announcements about jobs in terms of rehabilitation of bogs. But those jobs are only handfuls, and they won't offset the huge number of jobs that are currently being lost. And to add insult to injury, we have German lignite briquettes being imported into the country at a time when, you know, the workers are out of their jobs, unemployed. And these workers and their families, when they go to their local shop and they see these German lignite briquettes, it's adding insult to injury. It's going too far. And I think what needs to happen is government need to take 10 steps back. They need to be fair with the people of the Midlands. They're not listening. I know I've raised this issue a number of times. They need to just show fairness. I mean, we could indeed do it a better way, a fairer way. Workers who have mortgages and bills to pay need to be given a fair chance. And I suppose also it's ironic when you think that a Bordenham Mona worker or a person in horticulture or a contractor, a peat contractor who's now out of work, has to be over 15 months in receipt of job seekers before they can actually get the fuel allowance. Now, I just think that's crazy. And I've called this out this morning. But what I'm calling on also is Midlands TDs to step up to the mark, to grow a backbone, and to stop trying to have one foot in the green camp and another foot in with the workers. We need somebody, and we need TDs who are going to lead the way. So I've called on them this morning to support me in this, and to make sure that we bring this back to the drawing board. And also I want to say that Bordenham Mona has treated their workers very, very badly. The first the workers heard of the peat harvesting was when it was printed in a national newspaper. I think there should have been engagement with their loyal workforce, and I'm calling that out as well. So we want an end to the harebrained, unhinged environmental ideas. The Midlands alone isn't going to save the planet. And given that Ireland only contributes 0.1% of the emissions in the world, there needs to be some sort of a wake-up call here and a dose of reality. We can't allow our own people to suffer or to endure hardship for the cause of a green cause that makes no sense. People need to put food on the table. People need to pay bills, and aspiration alone won't do that.
And what's the feeling on the ground among your constituents? Are they resigned to this being a final decision by the government, or is there enough anger maybe to try and turn things around?
There's an awful lot of anger. There's an awful lot of anger and disillusionment that politicians from the government parties aren't listening. And that's what I'm calling for today, is for them to get behind their people. The people who voted for them need representation. They need to listen to the constituents. Certainly what I'm hearing is floods and floods of complaints from workers. They don't know where they stand. Bordenham Mona hasn't been up front with their workforce. The workers don't know how long they have in their jobs. They don't know how much stock of peat is left. And there's an awful lot of uncertainty and disillusionment. But I believe that this frustration will actually lead to the downfall of a number of government TDs if they don't wake up and step up to the mark and represent their constituents.